Hello everyone, in this video we will see the 8086 multiprocessor configurations. So what is the need for multiprocessor configuration? A single processor may not be good enough to process or to carry out all the operations required for an application. Say for example, you might require string manipulation for some applications, you might require code conversion for some applications, some applications require trigonometric functions. So all these put together in a single processor might not be cost effective, because for some applications those would have been extra features which are not at all required. So the more cost effective solution is to use multiprocessor configuration than to use a single complex processor. So based on the need, the other processors might be used in the system for the required application. So in that, the advantages are the cost performance ratio. So based on the requirement, so the cost that has been put is comparatively lesser for multiprocessors than for a single complex processor. Then, depending upon the application needs, different kind of process can be fitted for the application. Then, if it is going to be a multiprocessor configuration, it provides room for expansion. So you can keep on adding the other processes so that depending upon the need, it could have been satisfied. So this type of modularity is another great advantage. And then in the case of failures, it is easier to replace the failed part and that processor compared to replacing the entire operation. So even in the case of failures, these multiprocessor configuration are advantages. Next, so if we go to the disadvantage, or rather it is a challenge. So there are two problems associated with multiprocessor configuration. One is bus contention. So if we have more than one processor in a system and they share a common bus, then which processor should have control over the bus, which should be the bus master? So that contention becomes a problem, and there are ways to resolve these contentions. The next one is, having more than one processor in the system, they should be able to communicate with each other. So what is the communication mode or means by which these two or more processors communicate? So those things are the challenges. So when we have multiprocessor configuration, we have already seen it is the maximum mode. So we have a min-max pin which should be configured for maximum mode configuration, wherein we can use go in for multiprocessors. Basically, 8086 supports three multiprocessor configuration. First one is the coprocessor, second one is the closely coupled configuration, third one is the loosely coupled configuration. So going by the block diagram, if you see here, we have the 8086 or 8088, okay, so 8086 processor here, and another coprocessor or an independent processor, okay, connected here, and the bus control logic, and you have memory and IO and the clock. So what we need to see here is, if a coprocessor is used, it is coprocessor configuration. If another independent processor is used, then it is a closely coupled configuration. Why we say closely coupled configuration is, all these two processors, either it could be a coprocessor or independent processor, they have the common clock and they have the same bus control logic and they share the same memory and the IO devices. So there are no separate memory and IO for the coprocessor or independent processor. So if when they share the same resources, then we call them as a closely coupled configuration. Okay, so that's what is given here. We will have only one 8086 processor in a coprocessor configuration, And since it is called as a coprocessor, it cannot act independently. So it will act as a slave to the 8086. 8086 processor will act as the master and the coprocessor will act as a slave. So the control will be transferred from the 8086 to the coprocessor for it to execute. After execution of the coprocessor, the control will go back to the master processor, which is the 8086. So as you have seen earlier, it shares the same bus control logic and clock generator. Okay. So going to the next, closely coupled configuration. Here also we have only one 8086 processor, whereas the supporting processor is an independent processor. It does not require the, it can act independently, whereas the coprocessor cannot act independently. Here in closely coupled configuration also, it shares the same bus control logic and the clock generator with the 8086. Next type of configuration is the loosely coupled configuration. If you see here, we have on the top, we have 8086, which has got its clock and it has got its own system bus control logic and a local bus control logic, local memory, local IO device. So this 8086 will have a local bus control logic, local memory and local IO devices. Similarly, if you see here this is a 8086 plus 8087. So another, it could be coprocessor. Okay. So this also has its own local memory and IO devices. And if you see the third one, closely coupled multiprocessor model. So instead of coprocessor, this could be an 8086 along with another independent processor. So they again have a local memory and IO device. If you see here, there are three different processors, 8086. So this is a separate model, this is a separate model, this is a separate model. So each of them has got their own local IO devices and IO local memory. Then why is it called as loosely coupled configuration? Because they also share the system bus in a common way and they share some system memory and system IO devices. So here they have got high independence. They can process their own system separately. So the processes could be concurrent here. So parallel processing is possible here. At the same time, they also share certain resources like the system memory and the system IO devices. So this loosely coupled configurations, they are intended for medium to large size systems. So we will have more than one bus master which run independently and no connections between them. As we have seen earlier, each of the 8086 have their own resources. Okay, and each processor may include its own memory and IO devices, and the processor communication between themselves is through shared resources. As you have seen, you have shared memory, system memory and system IO devices. So that is with respect to the loosely coupled configuration. So this is what we have seen in this video. Maximum mode, it supports multiprocessor configuration. It supports three modes of configuration: coprocessor configuration, closely coupled configuration and loosely coupled configuration. In the coprocessor configuration, so the coprocessor is a slave processor. It cannot act independently and it will share the resources with the 8086 processor. The next one is closely coupled configuration. Here we have an independent processor, but still it will share the system resources with 8086. No separate resources for the independent processor. The last one is a loosely coupled configuration in which each of the processor will have its own resources, and it might be a single 8086 processor, or it could be along with a coprocessor, or it could be along with another independent processor as in closely coupled configuration, and all of them will interact with using a shared memory and IO devices. So with this, we will stop this video.